Welcome back, part three of the Mack Superliner convoy build. Now, in the further two videos, we did the frame, front steering, and now what we're going to concentrate on is the rear end of the truck, suspension and driveline. So what I'm going to do, see if I can work this out right, if I've done this right. Leon. So these outtakes are going to be hellish. So what we're going to do, we've got the framework again. These here is your rear airbags. One, two lots there. Basically, I'll take them off because they're going to fall off eventually. They're just your rear wheels for when I put the rear axle together, but I'll just take them off the frame for now. Tell you what I did do once on one of me when I was new to this truck kit, on the frame I thought this bar here had to be cut away, so I cut the airbags off it instead, didn't I? But I managed to get them put back together anyway. So that's the airbags off the frame. And we need the rear shock absorbers, which that's in there, there's four. These parts here are your rear axles. There's two of them. You've got your rear leaf hangers, which is four parts. You've got that part there, which is one of the driveline hubs. These here are the tank supports for holding the fuel tanks. That's there for your fifth wheel. So what I'm going to do, just put that section to one side for now again. We're going to concentrate building these airbags up. As you want, you notice there's no bags on the other side, so the old trusty glue. Now on the single part of these airbags, you've got location tabs, as you can see. So they will match up to the frame when they go into place. So as you can see, that's one in place. You can see where the, zoom in, location marks is on top of the airbags. Each truck kit's different, from American to Euros. Depends which one you want to build. Please, I'm off work today. Nice day off. Right, so now, that's one of the airbags built. Now, this airbag here, you can see it's got a recess in it. So, look at the instructions. And you've got the shock absorbers. One shock absorber's got a pin mark on it, which goes inside the frame. And that lug there sits on the inside of there. So what we're going to do, we shall caught the ball, Cinderella said. Well, look at the framework. Underneath, you've got location marks for the airbags. So the way this works, I shall show you. Now these airbags will sit in place with the lugs on the top into the frame. Bear in mind, if you've got the frame straight from when you built it, it all should go into place. One airbag in place. Like playing with Lego, really, but you're not you. With Lego, you don't use glue. That's it. Now, I don't know if you can make this out. As we're saying on the inside the frame here. I've got the knife point, you've got location points for the shot absorbers. That bit didn't take well with that bit of glue, so reapply. So there we are, we've got the shockers in place now. And that's the airbags and shockers in on the frame. So we'll put that to one side, let that dry up. And next what we're going to do, we've got the spring hangers. So detach them off the frame. When you get everything painted up and primed up, want to get the chassis painted matte black, and then what you need to do, it's up yourself how far you want to go into detail with this. I using silver paint, picking out the shockers and springs and bits and bobs, but it's up to the individual how they want to paint it and how much detail they want to go into it. Now with doing this truck build for a convoy, there will be a lot more detail going in. So now I've detached them four pieces. And I'm looking at the instructions, so what we do now, take off the rear axle frame bits. We've got the other frame. Now on this frame we've got your brake cylinders, which is them four there. Now when you build this up, it tells you which way to put on, which way to go, and I'll show you that in a wee bit. I mean, like when I'm building these, I like to get all the parts off ready, put them in order where we're going, so you're not losing parts when you take them off eventually. So we'll go back to the frame. Now, each one of these on the frame there, on the airbags, I've got little lug stops. And when you look at your spring hangers, it tells you which way, straight forward, which way to go. See, dry fit once and then glue. So you make sure the part fits correctly. And one of the videos, what's coming shortly, will blow your mind. It does mine every time I do it. It's chrome stripping. When I'm stripping chrome, I use bleach. Sometimes it strips straight away, and sometimes it takes 10 minutes or so. But trust me, brilliant. Right, so we've got the rear leaves in place now, glued in. See, the frame's coming on quite canny. Damn, scan your cup. It's cold, killing me. It's horrible. So now we've got your rear axle parts. Still, again, dry fit. Make sure it all fits together quite nicely before gluing. Some parts may need cleaning off from where you cut them off from the frames. Now, the rear hubs, discs, They've got little marks, delves in, which fit into the axles parts, and they've got like squares on the side, so basically you kind of misplace them. So there's one part done. Let that dry, and then we will apply the master cylinders to go on there, on the axles. You got the other axle there, now I'm going to glue this one together. So there we are, that's another axle built, so that's two drive axles done. Right, so as I was explaining, there's two different sizes for these master cylinders, so there is lugs marked on them. Yeah, but then, dead easy. It's one axle done. Now all these little parts, what you've done on the axles, you can pick them out. I with the chrome pen. I've showed you all before, but when it's all painted up, then I can show you more into detail. Second axle done. Right, so now we need 59B, which is the main drive axle, to go between the two axles, which is that one there. That one off the frame. So got your frame back upside down again. You got your two drive axles and center drive. Now on each one of these you've got little lugs marked out what the axles sit in place. There's one accident. This is the tricky bit. You need three pairs of hands to do this. I've only got one. So, wish me luck. There's a drive line in place on that axle. So it goes into there. That's what I'm saying, you need three pairs of hands. I know this video has run over the time which I allocated for it. You just have to bear with me for 1 minute. Right, there we are. Rear drive line installed on your frame. So that's it for now. We'll catch you all later.